Thanks for your patience. Without further ado, please allow me to present to you my dear friend, Kim Holm.
Hello, I'm going to read three short Lovecraft prose poems by H.P. Lovecraft for you, with Bjørn Ognøy and Espen Solheim. First is Ex Oblivione.
To a dog.
what the moon brings. shrieked, lest the hidden face rise above the waters, and lest the hidden eyes look at me after the slinking away of that leering and treacherous yellow moon. And to escape this relentless thing, I plunge gladly and unhesitatingly into the stinking shallows, where amidst weedy walls and sunken streams, fat sea worms feast upon the world's dead.
Memory. In the valley of leaves, the cursed waning moon shines thinly, tearing upon for its light with feeble horns through the lethal foliage of a great Ufos tree. And within the depths of the valley, where the light reaches not, move forms not meant to be beheld. Rank as the herbage on each slope, where evil vines and creeping plants crawl amidst the stones of ruined palaces, twining tightly broken columns and strange monoliths, and heaving up marble pavements laid by forgotten hands. gigantic and crumbling courtyards leap little apes. While in and out of treasure walls writhe poison serpents and scaly things without a name. Vast are the stones which sleep beneath the coverlets of dank moss, and mighty were the walls from which they fell. For all time did their builders erect them, and in sooth they yet served nobly. For beneath them the grey toad makes his habitation. At the very bottom of the valley lies the river Tharn, whose waters are slimy and filled with weeds. From hidden springs it rises, and to subterranean grottos it flows, so that the demon of the valley knows not why its waters are red, nor whither they are bound.
Genie flew back to the
Tusen takk til Bjørn Ognøy og Espen Solheim. The plan is to make a quadrilogy of these three stories and the last one, and make books of them, but I've only made one of them into a book yet. But if anyone wants them, and I have 10 preview copies of the last story, Memory, so come talk to me if you want one. And thanks to Vivek for being Vivek.